Good morning. Let us pray. Heavenly and most gracious Father, Lord, as we come before you this morning, God, we want to thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Lord, we thank you for your mercies this morning, O God. Father, we thank you, God, for sparing our lives, for seeing yet another day. And God, even as we are standing in your presence, Lord, we just want to thank you for being a faithful Father. We want to thank you for being on time, God, a God that we can look to, a God that we can call upon in a time of need and in a time of sorrow. This morning, God, I ask that you would release your blessings over this morning proceedings, O God. Father, I ask, O God, that your blessings, your covering, and your divine protection, Lord, will continue to rest upon, Lord, Grantley Adams Memorial Secondary School. Father, I pray, O God, that goodness and success would always be showcased in this school, O Father. Lord, I pray that every gifting, O God, that you have placed in the life of every student, Lord, it will be facilitated and it will come to pass in due season. Father, this morning, as we seek to relaunch this bullion program, Father, we pray this morning, O God, that we would all seek to be a buddy and not a bully. I pray right now, God, that you would touch the minds and the hearts of every single student of this school. Father, we understand that your word states that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, God, but against principalities and spiritual wickedness in high places. So, Father, in the midst of knowing, oh God, being able to curb bad behavior, Father, we understand that there's a spiritual component to it. And this morning, God, we cancel every plan of the enemy. Lord, we curtail, Father, every spirit of rejection, God. Father, every spirit of anger, God, anything at the root that would cause a student to want to take out their anger upon another, oh Father, we cancel it in the realms of the Spirit. Father, this morning, God, we release your blessings upon them. We ask right now, God, that you would cover them, Lord, as they go out, God, and as they come back in. And we pray, oh Father, as a result of this program being relaunched, Lord, that this secondary school would be a better place. Lord, I ask right now that you would anoint, Lord, the teachers, God. You would anoint, God, the auxiliary staff. You would anoint, God, every single person on this premise. And we cover this school, Lord, under your precious blood. And we release your peace this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. You may be seated at this time. At this time, we want to welcome Mr. Jason Bino, Chairman of the Bully Prevention Coordination Committee of Grantley Adams Memorial School. Would you put your hands together and welcome Mr. Bino as he comes and gives you the official welcome.
Mr. Corey Lane, Minister of State in the Office of the Attorney General with Special Responsibility for Crime Prevention. Mr. Sean Clark, CEO of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development and Certified Bullying Prevention Trainer and Consultant. Major Andrew Skeet, Principal of the Grantley Adams Memorial School. Mr. George Griffith, Chairman of the Board of the Grantley Adams Memorial School. Pastor Jamal Midas, members of staff of the Grantley Adams School, members of the Supreme Counseling for Personal Development, Mrs. Sherry Toll, Chairman of the Bullying Prevention Coordinating Committee of St. George Secondary School, students, members of the media, other distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. My name is Jason Bino. I am the chairman of the Olweus Anti-Bullying Prevention Program at the Grantley Adams Memorial School. And it is my job today to welcome you to this event. We thank you, those of you who would have taken your time to come to this or relaunch of the Anti-Bullying Program. And we are delighted to have you with us. It is our goal at the Grantley Adams Memorial School that we are able to raise the quality of life of every student that passes through this school. And it is our belief that through this program, we will be able to raise that quality of life, not only in the school, but outside of the school, in the communities, in all of the areas in which these students will be placed. The program, or the goal of this program, is not only to highlight the bullying that may occur within the school, but it is to inculcate the behaviors that we would want to see not only within the school, but within our communities. And we are seeing what is going on within the communities recently. And I'm sure Mr. Lane will highlight some of those issues which we are having. So we want to stamp out not only bullying, but the unwanted behaviors within the communities and within the schools. And we join with St. George Secondary School and the Frederick Smith Secondary School as we start this program here at the Grantley Addis Memorial School to seek to dispel those behaviors. So again, I want to welcome you and I thank you all for being here, and we do hope that you enjoy the program. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your kind words, Mr. Baino. And now we will be having the opening address by Major Andrew Skeet, principal of the Grantley Adams Memorial School.
Mr. Corey Lane, Minister of State in the Office of the Attorney General, with special responsibilities for crime prevention, our Chairman, Mr. George Griffith, Mr. Sean Clark, CEO of Supreme Counseling, other specially invited guests, staff, students, the media, a blessed good morning to all of you. Good morning. Come on, we can do much better than that. Good morning to all of you. Yes, we shouldn't have to beg you so hard to be polite. I think too much of, I would say, to your joy this morning. I'm not going to be too long, but I couldn't not take the opportunity just to say a couple of things to you as we relaunch this anti-bullying program at Grantley Adams Memorial School. And as I was sitting and speaking with the minister, he basically confirmed a thought I had in my head. And the question really is, should children only be in the possession of academic, for example, maths, English, social studies, and science skills, or skills in the vocational trade, electrical installation, barbering and cosmetology, furniture making? That's really the question. And I think if we reflect on this, some of you children may wish to say on the contrary, the answer really is no. These yes are critical and important as they provide the foundation for career or even future educational pursuits. But poor attitude, being unable to communicate, being unable to address conflict and address conflict correctly, being able to work in a team, having a very, very positive attitude towards life and work, I believe are more critical and very important to the success of any individual. In fact, anybody who watches sports, we see there are many, many cricketers, footballers who have immense talent, but a bad attitude has cost them fortunes because nobody really wants to work with them. I believe here, we at Grantley as a Morris School, as Jason did say, we are trying to be deliberate in our approach to inculcating these, I would call them skills, some say values, in our daily instruction. With some with mixed success, yes, we have one or two children who would want to continue to try to create some confusion, not for us, but for themselves, who may want to kick against the bricks sometimes, who may want to do things that we know and they know they shouldn't do. But it doesn't mean that we are not going to continue to try. Hence, and let me at this point thank Supreme Counseling for ensuring that we remain a part of, and I dare say, sorry, St. George, high priority on their list of schools in the delivery of this and other programs aimed at building what we would call the socio-emotional skills of our children. For providing the opportunity through the Olweus Bullying Program and the Supreme Beings for our students to receive both formal and informal instruction on how to develop communication skills, how to develop teamwork skills, and how to learn to deal with conflict. Grantley as a Morris School will, sir, commit to ensuring that you are given the space, the time, I don't want to say the total freedom, but with consultation, the opportunity to come here and to do your work. We know in our discussions you've already committed to another program which you're in the process of formulating. And as that becomes available, we will let those who will be involved aware. I also want to encourage you children not to see today as an opportunity to put on a pretty shirt and a pair of tight jeans or distressed jeans, a pair of slippers. I see some children in this morning. Not to see it only as an opportunity to dress down, but a dare to recommit yourselves if you haven't, or to commit or recommit those who have not, to positive behaviors. And in this instance, being a part of the anti-bullying campaign. To one, not to practice it, and two, to call it out. Yes, more important, to call it out. To tell your colleagues, your classmates, no, do not do that. We are not accepting that, and that's not a part of the culture at Grantley Adams Memorial School. We are all called to be leaders. And to be true leaders, we have to show courage. And while you may call it ratting out or snitching or whatever the case may be, I'm calling on you to call it out. We are called, as I said, to be leaders. I am reminded of a piece of scripture in Romans chapter 12 and verse 18. And it simply says, as is as much as is up to you, as it depends on you, live peaceably with everyone. Yes, it depends on you. It's calling you to act. It's calling you to do something. And I'm encouraging each and every one of you today just to say to yourself, yes, it depends on me. I have to contribute to the reduction of bullying at Grantley Adams Memorial School, and I will do so. So let's be buddies and not bullies. Master, our ceremony staff, students, and all, especially invited guests, thank you. And like Jason, let's have a very, very good program this morning. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Major Skeet, for that lovely opening address. Students, I hope you were listening to his words carefully, as He would like you to stay committed to being peaceful students and being proactive in stopping bullying. Also, please remember that you're all in this together. So you can only have a better environment if you yourselves are also contributing to making the environment better. I will now like to quote a message from Miss Donna Clark, project manager of the Maria Holder Memorial Trust, who has responsibility for this project but could not be here today. And I quote, "I am sorry I could not be present this morning for your school's relaunch of the Olweus Bullying Prevention Program. This is a very relevant and necessary program, and I trust that all of you will embrace what the team at Supreme Counseling for Personal Development, teachers, guidance counselors, parents, and all involved are trying to achieve to make the school a safe, no-bullying learning environment. The OES Bullying Prevention Program is recognized as one of the world's most researched bullying prevention programs. It has yielded positive results in schools that have undertaken and embraced this program in other countries and those schools here in Barbados that are using this model to tackle the issue of bullying. Most have indicated that bullying has decreased, thus resulting in a positive change in the school climate. A child who feels unsafe at school will not thrive and therefore find it difficult to focus on schoolwork. The Merriam-Webster Dictionary defines bullying as the abuse and mistreatment of someone vulnerable by someone stronger and powerful, prone to or characterized by overbearing mistreatment or domination of others. In other words, bullies tend to target individuals weaker than them in the physical sense or emotionally fragile from a mental or emotional standpoint. Often bullies are themselves victims of bullying, so their rebuff is to target someone else. Supreme Counseling for Personal Development aims to tackle the issue of bullying using a holistic approach, focusing on the school, classroom, individual, and community levels. As project manager for this program, and with the Maria Holder Memorial Trust being the primary funder of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development Project Rescue Program, we recognize the impact and positive results yielded by participants in other schools that have implemented and embraced this program. I am pleased that the OES Bullying Prevention Program is being relaunched at your school today. It tells me that you and all involved are willing to eradicate bullying in your school. If you see one of your peers being bullied, do not be afraid to report it to a teacher or the principal. This is the only way the problem can be dealt with early and avoid escalating into something more serious. I implore each and every one of you to be each other's keeper. Lean on each other for support and guidance. Continue to build long-lasting relationships and friendships and use the lessons learned as you traverse through life's wonderful but sometimes complicated journey. My simple message to you today is to say no to bullying. Thank you, Supreme Counseling for Personal Development, and all those involved in this relaunch this morning. Here ends Ms. Clark's quote. Thank you for listening.
All right, so you know, our focus here is to reduce bullying so that we can help to improve our school environment, not only our school environment, but the culture of our country. At this time, I want you to put your hands together, and we want to welcome Miss Jane Small as she come and minister a song. Please put your hands together and welcome her.
Good morning.
That I will have to climb, and there will be battles that I will have to fight, but victory or defeat is up to me to decide. But how can I expect to win if I never try? I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I've started from. And nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't He's brought me this far to leave me. Never said there wouldn't be trials. Never said I wouldn't fall. Never said that everything would go the way I wanted to go. But when my back is against the wall and I feel like hope is gone, I just lift my head up to the sky and say, help me to be strong. Oh, I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I've started from. And nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. I know you didn't bring me out here to leave me lonely, and even when I can't see clearly, I know from where I've started from. And nobody told me that the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. I just can't give. I've come too far from where I've started from. And nobody told me that the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. I just I've started from, and nobody told me that the road would be He's brought me this far to lead me. I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I've started from. And nobody told me that the road would be easy. And I don't believe He's brought me this far to leave me. Thank you.
Kiko!
Y'all can do better than that. Another round of applause for Miss Small.
Relax your face, Massa.
Next up, we will be having an address by Mr. Sean Clark, CEO of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development and Olweus Certified Bullying Prevention Trainer and Consultant. Just a short bio about Mr. Sean Clark. He is the Chief Executive Officer of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development and Managing Director of SMC Consultants. He holds qualifications in social psychology and counseling. He completed his master's degree in the area of HR management with Surrey University, England, and now specializes in the field of human resources development. Sean is one of two certified Olweus bullying prevention trainers and consultants in the entire Caribbean and is a member of the International Bullying Prevention Association. He also sits, well, yeah, you could clap for that. He also sits as the association's point of contact for the Caribbean region. Sean serves as the deputy chairman of the board of management of the Ellerslie School and a member of the National Task Force on Wellness. He is also a member of the board of management of the Barbados Alliance to End and a trustee with the But God Project. He has conducted a number of seminars on effective team building, leadership, management of change, stress, and stress management, and several other topics, both in Barbados and abroad. In recent times, Sean has implemented a bullying prevention program in 6 schools in Antigua and Barbuda, and is currently in talks with a number of other Caribbean countries who expressed an interest in the Olweus bullying prevention program. He was the featured speaker in St. Lucia, speaking on the topic, the cost benefits of having a bullying prevention program. In 2012, Sean was awarded the Rotary West Vocational Award in recognition of his outstanding service and contribution to humanity. Give a round of applause for Mr. Sean Clark.
No, everybody know about Sean, no. So when bad mind a try stop me, every day me pray chant a psalms. Yeah, work hard for me cheddar every day and night. No busy doing folly in a your eyesight.
A blessed good morning to each and every one of you. I always make it a point to have my good friend Jean Small sing just before I deliver any speech, because she acts as a source of motivation for me. I have started as well to make it habit to have my good friend Pastor Jamal Mendes open prayer for us at any of our events, again because of the level of motivation, sir, that you bring to the table. Mr. Corey Lynn, Minister of State in the Office of the Attorney General with Special Responsibility for Crime Prevention. Major Andrew Skeet, Principal of the Grantley Adams Memorial School. Pastor Jamal Mendes, members of staff of the Grantley Adams Memorial School, members of staff of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development, Mrs. Sheritel Sobers, Chairman of the Bullying Prevention Coordinating Committee of St. George Secondary School, members of the media, students, other distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Chairman of the Board of Management of Grantley Adams. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It gives me great pleasure and a sense of pride to join the Grantley Adams Memorial School family today as they relaunch and reconfirm their commitment and participation in the Olweus Bullying Prevention Program. Allow me, my friends, to congratulate the management and staff and students of this esteemed institution for the decline in bullying over the past year. The statistics speak for themselves. In 2019, when we at Supreme Counseling for Personal Development surveyed this school to ascertain the prevalence of bullying amongst its students, the level of bullying stood at 18%. 8% were bullied, and 10% bullied others. We resurveyed the school in 2022, at which time the level of bullying stood at 11%. 7% were bullied, and 4% bullied others. Minister Lynn, in that time period, the number of students who were bullied fell by 1%, and the number of students who bullied others fell by 6%, an overall reduction of 7%. You can clap for that. Similarly, we surveyed the St. George Secondary School students in 2018 before they became a part of the Olweus family. At that time, bullying stood at 22.3%. 12% were bullied, and 10.3% bullied others. Again, Mr. Minister, we resurveyed the students in 2022, months after we launched the Olweus Bullying Prevention Program there. The statistics for 2022 indicated that 11% of students at the St. George Secondary School were directly involved in bullying. 5% had been bullied, while 6% had bullied others. Mrs. Telsobers, that says to me that at your school, students who were bullied fell by 7%, and those who bullied others fell by 4.3%, an overall decline in bullying by 11.3%. You can also clap for that. The Olweus Bullying Prevention Program works only if you work the program. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to humbly suggest that bullying prevention is crime prevention. Bullying is a problem of epic proportions in schools, on the playground, at work, and even at home. Pastors, educators, and community leaders see bullying as a devastating form of abuse that can have long-term effects on youthful victims, robbing them of self-esteem, isolating them from their peers, causing them to drop out of school, and even prompting health problems and suicide. Bullying, therefore, can be a gateway behavior, teaching the perpetrator that threats and aggression are acceptable even in adulthood. In one study by Fight Crime Invest in Kids, nearly 60% of boys who were classified as bullies in grades 6 to 9, first to third form, were convicted of at least one crime by the age of 24, while 40% had three or more convictions. This revelation was made by Dr. Dan Olweus in 1984, when he stated that the aggressors often prize violence as a way to solve problems. They are impulsive and have little empathy. If their rule breaking is not addressed, they may apply their behavior to other antisocial activities such as criminality and drug abuse. By the time they are 24 years old, 60% would have committed a crime. In the UK, research suggests that young people who bully have a 1 in 4 chance of having a criminal record by the age of 30. Bullying is real, and we in Barbados need to start seeing it for what it is. The reality is that when you compare aspects of bullying to the law, we see how it fits. Physical bullying is assault. Rumors and lies, defamation of character. Cyberbullying is stalking. So that we can no longer see bullying in isolation or as a rite of passage, but as a violation of one's personal rights, as an act of degrading and demoralizing and destabilizing someone, of raping someone of what should be an enjoyable and memorable life. In 1983, the Minister of Education in Norway invested in a national campaign after 3 boys committed suicide. They called on Olweus and his bullying prevention program. 42 schools in Norway participated. After 2.5 years of study, reported cases of bullying in participating schools dropped by half. There was less theft, vandalism, and fighting. Students reported improved classroom climates with more positive social relationships and an eagerness towards schoolwork. It leads the questions to the powers here in Barbados, like the Calypsonian Rouser, and the older persons in the audience will know of whom I speak. Like that Calypsonian Rouser when he sang, "What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for?" We need to know what the authorities that be are waiting for to implement a national campaign in Barbados to help secure our children. My friends, the program works, but you have to work the program. Students, this is your program. You are the ones with the power to put an end to bullying at the Grantley Adams Memorial School. I want you to learn and remember the 4 bullying prevention rules. I need you to learn them like your school motto: equality, opportunity, service. I need you to remember these rules. I will not bully others. We will try to help students who are bullied. We will try to include students who are left out. If we know someone is being bullied, we will tell an adult at home and an adult at school. Treat everyone with respect. Nobody should be mean to others. I want you to stop and think before you say or do something that could hurt someone. If you feel like being mean to someone, find something else to do. Talk to a friend, read a book, or talk to an adult you trust. They can help you find ways to be nicer to others. Keep in mind that everyone is different. Not better, not worse, but different. If you think you have bullied someone in the past, apologize. Everyone feels better. The program works, but you have to work the program. The scope and impact of bullying demands an integrated and comprehensive approach, a holistic public approach. The bullying prevention efforts of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development will utilize this holistic approach to reduce incidences of bullying in schools in Barbados successfully. Accordingly, we have refocused our energies on the Olweus Bullying Prevention Program, and our next stop will be the Frederick Smith Secondary School. Consequently, we want to form the Olweus Bullying Prevention Oversight Committee, comprising the chairpersons of all participating schools and other members, to ensure that all participating schools are on the same playing field, together wrestling bullying to the ground. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I am obliged. Thank you.
We want to say thank you to Mr. Clark for giving you the statistics of the reduction in bullying and understanding the importance of the job that they're doing. They're not just doing it just because, but we want to have a better Barbados. Put your hands together again. And thank you, Mr. Clark. At this time, we're going to have a song, and it's going to be done by Khalil Callender. So would you please welcome him as he comes?
Good morning to everyone. I want to say thanks to Sean for having me again. This morning I'm going to be performing for you and I by John Legend, and I hope you enjoy.
You fit your makeup just so. Guess you don't know you're beautiful. Try on every dress that you own. You'll find in my eyes heaven oracle. And if your mirror won't make it any clearer, I'll be the one to let you know. Out of all of the girls, you're my one and only girl. And nobody in the world tonight. All of the stars, you make them shine like the wise. And nobody in the world but you and I. You and I. You stop the room when you walk in. Spotlights on, everybody staring. Till all of these boys that wasting their time stop standing in line, 'cause you're all mine. And this evening night, I won't let the feeling die. I never wanna leave your side. Out of all of the girls, you're my one and only girl. If nobody in the world, all of the stars, you make them shine like dim lights. If nobody in the world but you and I, you. No, no. You keep wondering if you're the one I wanted. You don't even have to try. You don't have to try. Oh, I don't try. Ain't nobody in the world but you. And I, all of the girls, you're my one and only girl. If nobody in the world but you. All of the stars, you make them shine like the wise. If nobody in the world but you. And I, if nobody. Ain't nobody in the world but you and I.
The Honorable Corey Lane, JP, NP, is the founder of a national youth intervention site and program, the Nature Front Ranch. Until recently, he was a moderator and a talk show host tackling local, regional, and international issues. As a former youth prime minister, he has an interest in current and global affairs from a tender age. He is an honored graduate of the University of the West Indies in sociology and political science, and is also an internationally trained youth and family counselor. Corey Rowell was recently elected as the Member of Parliament for the City of Bridgetown and was even more recently appointed as Minister of State in the Office of the Attorney General with responsibility for crime prevention. Corey is a God-fearing husband and father and have a 7-year-old daughter and a 5-year-old son. In June this year, Mr. Lane celebrated 24 years of community and volunteer service and has earned several awards. Some of these included National Volunteer of the Year and the Queen Scouts Award, the Point of Light Award from Her Majesty the Queen, and in March 2019, he became the youngest person to be honored with this prestigious Antonin Saber Caribbean Award of Excellence. While Corey carries many titles, he has assigned one to himself: humanitarian, someone who cares for humanity. Would you please welcome Mr. Corey Lane, Minister of State in the Office of the Attorney General with special responsibility for crime prevention.
Pull up that. Thank you, Master of Ceremonies, Chairman of the Board, Mr. Griffith and my friend, Principal Major Skeet, Principal and my friend, staff, teachers, well-wishers, CEO and team of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development, members of the media, and most importantly, students, boys and girls, young men, and young ladies. Now, I have the task today and the honor and the pleasure to address you this morning, to speak to you and to leave you with a message that I hope that can bring this society that we live in to be a better society. As I remember as a little boy, the saying, good, better, best, never let it rest until your good is better and your better is best. Is our good better? Is our better best? I am telling you here and now in Barbados, it is not. All is not well. We are going to need Pastor Jamal even more, because every morning in the news, we are hearing 2 and 3 shootings. But we did not wake up here one morning. It did not start here yesterday, last week, or last month. It started in the womb, how we develop our seed. It started in primary school. It started in secondary school. It started where you are sitting right now. And I feel like the right person to speak this morning, because just recently I was sitting where you were sitting, and I am not too old or higher up and better off to forget what I was thinking when I was sitting where you're sitting. I would have been thinking, what is this man going to talk about? Is this man going to bore me to death? Is this man going to talk long? Am I going to have to yawn till my jaw hurt me? That is what I would have been thinking, sitting where you are sitting right now. I hope I am pleased to tell you that the answer to all the above is no. I just come to deliver a short address, a short message, and I hope that by the time I leave here, that your mind is in a better position to put Barbados in the best position. I am here to tell you, first of all, that I and the government of Barbados supports this anti-bullying program, and we support Sean Clark and his efforts. And I want you to give him and his team a round of applause. Show us some appreciation. As we talk about anti-bullying, I want to talk about a lot of things. Anti-crime, anti-deviance, anti-fighting, anti-cursing and swearing and getting all bad. This program is designed to put these things in order. This program is to say to you that bullying is not good. Again, I am not old enough to forget that at school, at sometimes, just up the hill, that I too would have been considered a bully, although I did not consider myself a bully. I too am young enough to remember the feeling of having control over people, of having a posse behind me, and I feeling powerful and I feeling good. We gotta talk about these things in order to stand them out. I cannot stand up here before you and pretend that it did not feel good. I cannot pretend asking a first farmer for some money and getting it, how big that can make you feel, because I would be being dishonest to you. But at the same time, I am not too old to remember that as I reflect on it and think of the golden rule, how would it have made me feel with somebody doing it to me? Because the statistics are correct. Most people who are bullies are persons who are bullied. So you may be bullied at home. You may be bullied in your community. So you come to school now, and you look for the smallest person, and you bully them, and know you are the bully. But how did you feel when you were being bullied? Is that exactly how that person feels now you are bullying them? And I'm here with a simple, short message. Cut it out. Stop it. Cease and desist. Relax your face muscles, as the DJ say. Now, I know, because I sat there recently, that saying stop, cease and desist don't stop it automatically. And that is why there must be programs like the Olweus bullying prevention program. But I also know that it is not just okay to speak about anti-bullying and anti-crime. We got to talk pro, like we talk in pro wrestling. We got to talk about the things that we as a society, we as adults, we as parents, we as principal, we as the board, we as pastors will do pro. What will we bring to the table? I am proud to tell each and every one of you students here and teachers too, that the government of Barbados through the Ministry of Education is bringing education reform. And we've talked a lot about education reform. I am pleasantly surprised at what I have seen as the education reform platform, Sean. When I saw a teacher of 42 years of teaching, head of the education reform, I said, oh my goodness, we're in trouble. You cannot fix the problem with the same mindset in which it was created. But I am proud to say that teacher after teacher after teacher are in favor with the change. And they've been saying it for a while. Because ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, as adults, I always say, as I address children, we owe y'all an apology. The only one too, because they had to go through it too. School is very important. School teaches us academics, which are very important. But the OB apology, they've made it too boring. They've made it in a sense where it wasn't relevant. It has not changed with the time. And they made no apologies for saying it. Every single thing over the last 100 years have changed, and changed in a major way. I can tell you, a lot of our school system Established in 1929. Not 2029, I say 1929, and 1964 with major reformation, and some reforms happened after that. But 100 years ago, people were traveling in donkey carts. You don't see donkey carts now? 100 years ago, a computer was as big as this room. What is the size of a computer now? These handheld things called phones are computers. 100 years ago, we did things so much differently. But today, we still have the chalk and the talk and the syllabus as we believe we are living 100 years ago. But I can tell you that all the research is saying that by 2030, a lot of the jobs that exist now will not even exist. The world is moving into robotics, coding, renewable energy. Are these things that we are focusing on? And yes, I've said this before, and I will say until I see the change. So what are we going to be pro? I am proud to tell you that I was speaking to your principal just before this meeting, and he was telling me about a recording studio and radio station here at the Grantley Adams Memorial School, and the government of Barbados will do in all its in the power to support that initiative and initiatives like that. No, you got to clap for that. There are many things that you like that can be monetized. So we are going to continue to focus on the fundamentals, the academics, the ability to read and to write. But in there, we have got to make education more fun. We've got to make it more enticing. We've got to make it in a way that you can enjoy and that you can learn. A lot of you like sports. There must be more avenues for you to get involved in sports and get more scholarships. A lot of you have to see the 166 square miles of Barbados with pride, but understand that there's a whole other world out there. More of you have to get involved in traveling, to see in other parts of the world. Lots of you like extreme sports. I see you, your bicycle in the wheels in the air for half mile or 3 miles. We've got to put opportunities out there for our young people to get involved in extreme sports. A lot of you like music. Admittedly, you sing and listen to a lot of foolishness, but a lot of you sing good songs like what we heard today, inspirational songs. We have got to be the channel. We have got to facilitate you being able to pick up a microphone if you like singing and be able to create a career out of it. The world has changed. It is no longer 1929. Ladies and gentlemen, open your calendars. Open your phones. Look at the almanac, and you will see that this is 2022. And it is time to do things differently. Because if education remains irrelevant, if education remains boring, if you continue to have misery at school, at home, and in your community, you will be left no choice but to wake up every morning with two or three news stories of fatal shootings. So that is why we are going to bring the anti-bullying program, but we are going to bring some pro things, some things that you can enjoy and be a part of. I want to close this address because I told you ain't long and ain't a politician. I tell you, ain't long. Ain't a politician promise. Asking us to take these things more serious. Asking us to take every offense serious. I am asking every parent, every principal, and every police to take every report serious. Our research, like Sean is saying, that 60% of bullies go on to commit some form of crime. Our research is showing us that a lot of people report things from a young age. But as a teacher, you got a class full, you go sit back down. I'm going to tell you that. And that turns into retaliation at 2:30 and 3 o'clock. Parents, children come and report things to you. Man, what are you telling? I'm going to sit down. And that turns into fights in the school. Police. People report things, we ain't get to you. We ain't gonna warn the man, you know, we ain't got the vehicles, no, we busy. So people have to take matters in their own hands. Even some research I was looking at recently said that 44% of people in prison surveyed for gun crime say they have guns to protect themselves. And the reason that you feel you have to protect yourself is because if your parents are not protecting you, if the principal and staff are not protecting you, if the police is not protecting you, then you feel that you have the right and you have the need to protect yourself. That is why I am saying, just like in nursery, we do not allow you to take up a pencil because it could turn to grand theft. We are not going to allow you to bully because in 10 years you'll be on page one or page three as murderers. So we are going to stamp out the small things to prevent the big things. So this is what we need to do. And yes, the teacher there is telling you, please clap for that. So I am telling the teachers, I am telling you prefects, I am telling you all in authority, choose ye this day the Barbados you want to live in. Choose ye this day to stamp out the small things. Like in New York, have broken pins, where every little infraction you come down on and the big things go away. In this country, it's like soda bits, anything goes. People bike riding, noise up in the air, burning smoke, running through red lights. We say no. We can't just start with the murders. We gotta start with the small things. So teachers, I want all the shirt tails in. I'm telling the police, when you see students on the road, and I'm telling you adults, make them push in the shirt tails because it start there. When you start to break the rules, then you will break the laws. So I am saying we are going to get serious, but we are going to bring things as well to introduce to you to make sure that you have an enjoyable life. So I am asking you to choose dedication. Don't choose deviance. Choose discipline. Don't choose destruction. Choose determination so that you can shine with distinction. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I support this program and I ask you again to sign up today. Sign up for Judy to make Barbados good, better, and best. God bless you and God bless Grantley Adams Memorial School.
So sign up to make Barbados the best. Now remember what he said. It starts with each and every one of us. You have a responsibility. Mr. Corey Rowell, would you please come back to the... Lane, sorry. Would you please come back to the stage, please? We have a special presentation for you, and this will be done by Mr. Bino, the chairman of the committee.
Mr. Worrell, on behalf of the... Mr. Lane. Let's have it this way. Mr. Lane, on behalf of the Grantley Adams Memorial School, we want to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to come and encourage us to stop the bullying and the unwanted behaviors out of our schools and our communities. So we thank you very much.
My
We want to say a special thank you again on behalf of the Grantley Adams family. We want to thank you again for that timely message.
I will now invite Mrs. Tull Sobers to the stage, please. She is St. George Secondary School's committee chairperson, and she will also be making a presentation to the Grantley Adams Memorial School. Specifically, Mr. Bino, our coordinating committee chairperson.
Good morning, Grantley Adams. It is really a pleasure and a privilege to be able to offer this token of solidarity as the St. George family joins with the Grantley Adams family in the relaunch of your bullying prevention program. So once again, we applaud your efforts I like what Mr. Clark said. The program works, but you have to work the program. So therefore, as your theme says, I encourage all you students to be a buddy and not a bully.
And since sharing is caring, we will now have Mr. Bino offering his presentation, his gift, to Mrs. Tulsobers of St. George Secondary.
Yo, jump our cars.
We love to see it. So I know everyone is tired of the speeches, tired of all the talking. So now we will be entering to our entertainment segment. And firstly, we will be having your very own Kiara Gibson with a song. Kiara Gibson to the stage, please.
Look up. Yeah, man. Come on, everybody, say come.
We have all in for it. Jumping up on it. Having fun while we're young, let me enjoy it. I said we drink it and lug it. And I'm winding up like a...
If you know it, sing it.
This is how I enjoy it. Oh. Yeah. Yes, this is how I enjoy it. The atmosphere it crazy, the atmosphere it hype. So drunk I can't see clearly, but nothing can spoil midnight. Don't try to stop me, I'm going deaf. So don't tell me to take it easy. This is how I enjoy life. I see we celebrate it, celebrate it, celebrate it. This is how I enjoy life. I see we celebrate it, celebrate it.
Come let me jump up. I want to see everybody put your hand in the air right now. Put your two hands up. Put your two hands up. Come. Four times in the air.
Let me see my past. A long time I didn't see we all together. So, it's we time of year. Time up and party, drink and jump somebody, you don't know. Cause my team, we not partial, when it comes to fit, we not. These the vibes. We flow the libation, let me hype up. For the Adams right now,
push the two hands up in the air and sing.
We are one. Come join me and see.
Sing again. One.
Yeah, man. Cause we just drink together. And we just jump together. All together like
family.
So come let me drink together. And come let me jump.
Together.
Just side to side.
Show me some energy right now. Everybody who's up.
Hand up.
Go fast.
Four times in the air.
Let me see my posse. Come let me show them how to shell this place. Go stand up and stare. Come along and join in. Drink and put a smile across your face. Every line, every party we keep the red kicking like karate. Cause we the vibes.
The
bartender. I want the upstairs.
Show me some vibes. Come on, push your hands up.
We are one
big fainting family.
Come join me and see. We are one
big fainting family.
So come let me drink. Come let me jam. All together like
family.
So come let me drink. Come let me jam.
Take it down.
Don't stop it. If you against bullying right now, I want to see a push your hand in the air, so look. Nah, man. If you're about offering nobody, not nobody offering you, push your hand in the air, so look. Turn it up. That's what you're talking about. Turn it up. Come, pump your hands up. Pump it up.
Push your two hands up in the air and shake now.
We are one big fainting family.
Come join me and see. We are one big
fainting family.
Cause we just drink
together.
And we just jump
together.
All together like
family.
So come let me
drink together. Let me jump together.
Take it right down. Before you go, I want to hear a cappella. Sing!
We are... Come join me and see. We are one...
Wouldn't know that smart.
Cause we just drink tug. And we just jam tug. All together like... So come let me drink tug. Come let me jam tug. All...
stay blessed, each and every single one of you, for real. Somebody make some noise! Check. Whoa, look. Remember what we are here for. I want all the children to say, stop the bullying. Stop the bullying. Stop the bullying. Lyrics. Go school to learn, don't go school to fight. Stop bullying the children, then think that right. Education is a must, don't fight on the bus. Remember the boat, more might. All who agree with me, stop the bullying right now. Wave one hand left to right. Join the campaign, Supreme Counseling. Stop bullying now upon every school site. What I say? Stop the bullying. Say, stop the... What you say? Lyrics, lyrics. Little boy, little girl, brethren and sister, bullying thing, mashing up the school system. Stand up, everybody. Farm discipline, stop this foolishness. I hope you're listening. Don't hit nobody, not pinch nobody's skin. Straight to the headmaster, you will be jonesing. Listen to me, go and take in the learning. Follow Peter Romancing. Go school to learn, don't go school to fight. Stop bullying the children, them thing they right. Education is a must, don't fight on the bus. Remember the book more mighty than the knife. All who agree with me, stop the bullying right now. Wave on a hand left to right. Join the campaign, Supreme Counseling. Stop bullying now, upon every school site. Are your time, what you say? Stop the... What you say? What you say? Right. Pull up and hold. Hold it. Well, remember, we're in the month of November. And you see what's going on already. My sweet Barbados, let me see some hands in the air. Cause the more than fight is you I like every day. Hey, my sweet Barbados. Let me see your hands up again. Call him all up. Oh, why you sing that part now for me? Everybody, let me go so now. Blue, yellow, and blue. What you say? Blue. We don't hear new Barbados lyrics. A new Barbados lyrics. Hey, my son. Hold it.
Yo, Jumpa Records.
If you love your country, Barbados, just wave and say, Barbados. When I say, Bob, sing again. What? Barbados. When I sound good, weird, yeah. Low. I said low, don't turn off. You turn off your thing. It's a hard ears, man, yeah. Somebody said lyrics. Watch this now. Two, four, six of them is the best thing on the world map. 166 square miles, oak flat. Freestyle boy. Freestyle boy. 2, 4, 6 of them is the best thing on the world map. 166 square miles out flat. The sweetest women with the sweetest accent deserve a rum. Shh.
four system is the best thing on the world map. 166 square miles out flat. The sweetest women with the sweetest accent deserve a round of applause and a clap. Turbo bitch pretty to the ex. And let me finish now. Turbo bitch pretty to the exact. And the sand white just like this Independence Jack. We got the best prime minister. Me ya a more molly but blue yellow. You ever went to the... Watch this now. Tour guy. You ever been to the Gold Cup on the Garrison where you scrap? Or taste we good old monkey run by a snap? You ever been to Coast Road or Joint Boxes Road or went some food from St. Lawrence Gap? You ever went down Bathsheba to relax or get a red snap alongside the sea cat? You ever had a rose yellow big breadfruit get rammed down with sawfish? Lick your fingers, they're bound to come back. Whoa! That's the baddest thing in Barbados when it comes to freestyling. No, I tell myself that I'm going to enough schools this year, but from the time my brethren call me, holler for Peter, I'm going to do Grantley Adams, boy. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is here. So I here. So if you're proud of this school and want to love this school, give yourself a round of applause. I remember the message. Stop the bullying. Stop the bullying. Love one another. Listen to the teachers. Listen to your parents. Get your education. It's all about togetherness. And when it says togetherness, I'm talking about this. Shall rise. Red boys. Can I talk just a little bit? Can I really talk just a little bit? Can I really talk just a little bit? Hold it! You're coming in the dance. And you woke up ready. But you ain't bring no friends. Nor no family. You see the stranger on your left. You see the stranger on your right. Better start to jam up with them. Come if you sing in here to let them be chanting. Together we whining. Oh, lady. Let it in the morning. I want to hear you. You know why? Whatever you get, I wind on your bumper. You could push her over. You push him out. Everybody now getting his own. Nobody should do winding alone. Although we end up in one place, taking up space. This place is we home. We don't want that drama. Come to upset way. So by a jamming, for the last time. Together we drinking. Together we whining. One night we pumping. Set into the morning. Tell me how you're feeling. You know why? All away, we can have all away.
If y'all enjoy your surprise.
All away, whatever you get. I went on your bumper. The pump push up over.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna ask you guys to calm down a little bit now. We're coming on to the end of our program. Unfortunately, I know. So sorry. I will now invite Mr. Sean Clark, member of the Grantley Adams Memorial School Bullying Prevention Coordinating Committee, to do the vote of thanks. Could you all clap for Mr. Clark, please?
We are all one Grantley Adams family. Vote of thanks. I would like to say a good morning to all in attendance. As we have come to the end of our bullying prevention program launch, I come on behalf of the Grantley Adams Memorial School. All right, let us be quiet. Shh. All right. I, on behalf of the Grantley Adams Memorial School, would like to offer a vote of thanks to all who have participated. However, we would like to individually recognize and thank the following. The Minister of State in the Office of the Attorney General with special responsibilities for crime prevention, Mr. Corey Lane, who set aside time in his busy schedule to share his knowledge and to lend support to the launch of our bullying prevention program. We will all remember those words, stamp out the small things, and we will get rid of the big things. Stamp it out. The CEO of Supreme Counseling for Personal Development and Certified Bullying Prevention Trainer and Consultant, Mr. Sean Clark, my namesake, who tirelessly commit his time and experience to the students, helping them to develop valuable conflict resolution and leadership skills. The program only works if you work the program. Our energetic and driven principal, Mr. Andrew Skeet, who is always there to encourage and support any program that can boost the morale, knowledge, and skills of the staff and students alike. Pastor Jamal Mendez, for your prayers and your support. The members of staff of the Grantley Adams Memorial School and the Supreme Council, the members and staff of the Grantley Adams Memorial School and the Supreme Counseling for Personal Development, for your timeless support in ensuring that these programs are impactful in building the character of our students. I would also like to make special mention to Mr. George Griffith, who is our chairman, and on any occasion like this, he's always here to lend support, and we are honored to have you here, Mr. Foreman. Mr. Simeon Nichols, chairman of the Bullying Prevention Coordinating Committee of the Frederick Smith Secondary School, Mistress Charlie Tulsobers, chairman of the Bullying Prevention Coordinating Committee of St. George Secondary School, and our very own Mr. James Bino of the Bullying Prevention Coordinating Committee of the Grantley Adams Memorial School for their wisdom. We would like to thank them for their wisdom in seeing the need to set up and implement this program in their various schools. And remember, this is a relaunch for us. I would also like to thank Mr. Kimar Safer, President of the Barbados Alliance to End Homelessness, members of the media, and all specially invited guests who were here to encourage, entertain, and support our program launch. Plus, we can't forget the media team and the awesome students of Grantley Adams Memorial School. Without you, all of this would not be possible. To this end, I say thank you.